Hello, and welcome to a new game that's being kickstarted on Kickstarter.com called Deep Sixth. Usually that means something bad. Usually it means you got thrown out into space in a spacesuit. But this game, Deep Sixth, is a roguelike space sim that will force you to use strategy, ingenuity, and duct tape to keep your ship and your skull. I'm reading this from the Steam page. In one piece, as you risk exploring a mysterious nebula protected by dangerous alien creatures. Very interesting. Now, I have played the tutorial mission. I have not beat the tutorial mission, which is very interesting for a tutorial mission.
Okay, remind me again what we're out here doing.
So we're in the
Astra
tutorial.
Interstellar Solutions has tasked us with salvaging a D6 DSV that went missing in this nebula 13 days ago.
Right. The last log transmission received says they jumped over to a neighboring sector to mine a valuable yellow davorite deposit. Let's power up our deep space scanner and see if we can find that deposit.
If you notice the power allocation panel to the Astra Interstellar Solutions prides itself on the construction of all of its vessels. However, in the extremely unlikely event of a catastrophic systems failure, I am obligated to remind you that any problem can be solved by troubleshooting it in your field manual.
That's literally the least comforting set of words I have ever heard strung together before.
Maintaining optimism is essential for mission success. Would you like to hear an empowering speech?
No.
While we are waiting for the sector to get mapped, you should take the opportunity to check the ship for spare parts and tools. Most rooms have a drawer or a locker where important items may be found. I suggest you check this room's locker now.
All right. So yes, as she said,
you have found a used coffee cup, a hammer, and a universal controller board. Go ahead and drag those into your inventory now.
Huh? You mean pick them up?
It's got some humor to it. All right, we're going to take the hammer and the board. I haven't found a use for the cup of coffee yet, but we need to... Oh, it's going to make me pick it up? Fine.
Attention, pilot. The ship scanner is experiencing a malfunction.
Oh, seriously?
No. Please maintain optimism. I will guide you through the repair procedure. This is a great time to open the manual.
All right.
All troubleshooting can be accessed from the troubleshooting button. However, you can also find the same answers by clicking on an affected room. For now, click the troubleshooting button.
This manual is very useful. If we had this background knowledge where we lived in this world, we probably wouldn't have to resort to using the manual so often, but since we're new players in this, we have to.
Click the scanner failure button. Okay, it appears the first thing we need to do is go to the scanning room and check the main computer in there. Close the manual.
So this is actually the step-by-step repair procedures for things. Which is very cool. Alright, right click to
close. There's a map for easy navigation. The five viewing rooms on the ship are in a ring on the outside. Critical ship functions like power, the hyperdrive, and the scanner are located in the core of the ship.
I'm trying not to talk over the poor person. Yeah, the voice acting's pretty good in this game. Scanner room's here, which is in the center area. Then we got something else, which it won't tell us because we're in the tutorial. Engineering's at the bottom.
Attention, pilot. This room houses the deep space scanner. From here, you can assess what awaits you in nearby sectors and make any necessary repairs to the ship's battery. Let's check the computer. I see that there is an error code. Let's check the troubleshooting in the manual again. Click the green reference link to look up that error code. I see we have a hardware malfunction. Close the manual.
All right.
Go ahead and check the scanning hardware. It appears the old universal controller has burnt out. Swap in the replacement that you already found. That appears to have fixed things. Remember, the manual has a solution to every problem. And always maintain optimism. Now that the sector is scanned, I suggest we look at what the ship has found. Let's check the computer.
So if we hold down space, it tells us all the interesting things around us. Batteries, speakers, the AI server. Can't do anything with that currently. We got a locker up here, nothing inside. All right,
Analyze unknown anomalies until you find the yellow Davorite deposit the previous ship was searching for. Click on any sector with an anomaly, then click the Analyze button.
Analyzing. Yeah. Show us Davorite. Common deposit. No, that's not what we want. Come on, show us the money. Nope, not that one either. Hopefully it's this one with only one mysterious life form detected and not the two. I've met some pretty mean monsters in this game. Oh, it's not it. No, it is this one. Oh, that's gonna be interesting. What you got for me?
There it is.
Yep.
Now go to the hyperdrive room. Use the computer to set our destination and let us find that ship.
Alright, hyperdrive room is that.
Attention, pilot. This is where the hyperdrive and ship's life support systems are located. Your survival has been deemed a medium-level priority, and therefore the continued operation of these systems are considered to be desirable. Let's check the computer. First, click on the sector with yellow Davorite, then activate the hyperdrive.
And try not to mess with this. I got the cube out of alignment, and it took a minute and a half to get it back into alignment. It's very interesting. All right, we're gonna teleport there, or hyperdrive.
We're here. Any sign of the ship?
Sensors are detecting the asteroid, but no indication of high-energy laser use.
Huh. Weird. Anything else?
Sensors are detecting a minor artificial gravitational disturbance. I hypothesize that the D6 DSV was previously at this location, but subsequently departed using the hyperdrive. With additional power to the scanners, I might be able to assess its destination.
Well, in the meantime, we might as well mine that asteroid ourselves.
This is a good opportunity to explain laser operation to you. In order to mine the asteroid, we need to break it into smaller pieces and send a retrieval probe to collect a piece and return it to the ship. Firing lasers depletes battery power. You will need to either transfer power from other ship systems or go to the power room and refuel the reactor when this happens. Click on the laser configuration panel. There are two laser configuration types, steady frequency and modulated frequency. Clicking the buttons at the top change them. Open the manual and click on the rare minerals button. Click on the yellow Davorite deposit entry. Note that breaking up the asteroid requires a specific laser configuration and a specific amount of power going to that laser. Every time you fire the laser, the alignment shifts slightly, reducing its effectiveness. You can read more about this in the troubleshooting section. For now, confirm the laser configuration and power levels, then shoot the asteroid.
All right. I think we're good there. This is the room that we're in currently, this highlighted one. So we're going to lower power. Oh, I guess we didn't have to. There we go. So we got a charge 3, and we've got it set for this. This I have no idea what to do with yet. But let's target
the reticle is slow.
Adding power to the targeting subroutines will speed up weapons targeting.
Yeah, it means it can't fire until it turns green.
Now click on the local radar window, select an asteroid fragment, and launch a retrieval probe.
So the third room has a view of this. First room has a view of this. So if I wanted to shoot this piece, I would just have to switch over to another part of the ring here. Each room is very similar to the last one. So there's the yellow Davorite deposit. So if we lower these, we put 3 pieces in there,
Let us not forget why we are here. We need to search for the lost ship in a different sector.
Oh, right, right. And we gotta switch this. I almost forgot. Oh, and we're in this room here.
We're not alone here.
Uh-oh.
I sense external biological threats. You should prepare to defend the ship or get us out of here.
Local radar. We got an enemy in five. So if we switch over to room 5. Ooh, as you can see.
Attention, pilot. Irregular motion detected in the sector.
Oh, I know. We need to find out what that is. Where's the radar? Oh, there's two of them now. Oh, that's right, those two creatures. I want to get out of here. So, if we go to the hyperdrive room, if we go to Starbase, we immediately fail, but we're not charged up all the way.
The Goliath appears to be attacking the yellow Davorite. If you keep any of it around to mine, you are going to have to fight them off.
Yeah, you know what? We're gonna run like your other suggestion. Oh, so close. Oh, I think it hit us. Where's our integrity? Oh, no, we're at 100%. We're good. Local radar? Nothing. Okay, good. Oh, let's see what we can do here. We need to go to the scanner room. Scanning computer. Search for where they jumped to. Shipwreck. There we go. We found it. So we need now to go to the hyperdrive. Which is slowly charging. Now we can go to any of these rings and do other controls with the power. Let's see what it is targeting. Hyperdrive. So if we lower this now, get that powered up. Go back to hyperdrive. And it's a little faster. Definitely want to go to that shipwreck.
Attention, pilot. The ship scanner is experiencing a malfunction.
Scanning room. It's code 500, which, if we use our manual here, troubleshooting, scanner codes, code 500. The BIOS is corrupt. Select system admin, then BIOS restore for factory settings. System admin, BIOS restore, corrupted BIOS detected. Oh, it didn't tell us this part. Repair? System repaired. Okay, scanner is working again. And that is not scripted. That's a random event that will
Attention,
happen.
Attention, pilot. This room contains the power reactor providing energy to the ship's battery. From this room, you can also diagnose issues with power distribution.
Wait, then what?
Attention, pilot. The ship scanner is experiencing a malfunction.
Oh no, not again. So, if we need to put more fuel in here, we gotta put it through this door with these fuel. We only have 4. Let's go upstairs. Scanner's got troubles, but we're just waiting on the hyperdrive at this time. Almost there. But we may need to scan the area when we get there, so let's check the computer. Code 102. 102. Terminal motherboard failure. Open the panel underneath the scanner. Carefully remove the malfunctioning part. Scanning hardware? Oh, it's burned out again. So I've done this before. I took out the universal board from the battery, and I just popped that in there. And I think we're good. I think. Ship's battery. Oh boy, that's not a good thing. Oh, it didn't throw it out. I gotcha. But right now we need to put that in there anyway. So what we should do is search these other rooms.
Having a hard time catching my breath.
There is no air in here. Lungs
Attention,
are at
pilot.
The top.
atmospheric integrity is compromised. Air supply is a necessary component of pilot survival and is therefore considered desirable for the continued success of the mission.
Come on. There we go. All right, air is going to start filling up into here, but we need to get out of this room. Oh, there we go. There were some other rooms I've seen before. Deceleration field. That drained a lot of our battery power. The other lasers here are all part of that ring. It's very interesting. But our hyperdrive should be ready now. Yes, we can go to the shipwreck.
Okay, we're alive. We're alive, right?
One life form has been detected on board this ship.
Good, that counts. Any sign of the ship?
Detecting wreckage ahead. Verified. The missing D6 DSV has been detected.
There's not much left. Is anything salvageable?
Mission objectives updated. Astra Interstellar Solutions requests we use a probe to salvage the hyperdrive cube from the wreckage.
Alright, send in the probe. Didn't it say one life sign detected? Or is that us? We saw us. I gotcha. Scanner is still in trouble. We should probably search the other rooms for another board. The lockers are all in different spots. Radiation detector, vent, locker. We could take the first aid kit. We could dump the cup of coffee. And we could get a certification saying we're awesome. At least I think that's what it says. Alright, next room. Where is it? Where are you, locker? Primary console locker. We've got cable repair and radiation pills. That's useful. But our inventory is almost full already, so we'll just continue to look. Oh, a quantum cable. Grabbing it.
These creatures appear to be emitting a soft electromagnetic pulse to sense metallic objects. I'll route it through our speakers so we can hear what that wave sounds like.
Oh, behind us on 4. Probe is coming back with a cube right now. Big Clive just released a new video. Interesting. We'll just quiet my phone then. Oh, listen to that. They're like whales.
Attention, pilot. We are in custody of the salvaged hypercube. Primary mission objective complete. Astra requests that you photograph the damaged vessel, so they may study what went wrong. From the viewing room console, there is a button that will switch between the ship's lasers and the onboard camera. The camera toggle is located on the viewing room console, on the right side.
Okay. Oh man.
Suggest returning to base.
Photo taken. Return to base. I think we just won this tutorial level. That's not what I want. Why can't I? Oh, there it is. Hyperdrive. 100%. Back to base.
Okay. Okay, we're good?
I have uploaded our mission logs to Astra Interstellar Solutions. They have rated your performance. Satisfactory.
Aw, that's awesome. We got a little mining done. We got some target practice. It took 16 minutes and 16 seconds. And we've got 9 damage, so that hurt our score a little bit. But 476 points. Satisfactory, eh? That's good. We won the tutorial. What's 2 tries anyway, you know? Thank you everyone for watching. If you want to support this game, it's on Kickstarter. You'll find the link in the description. Thank you everyone for watching. This was Billy on the Good GMC channel signing off. Bye-bye.